I still remember the day my car's bumper got damaged. There I was, staring at the broken pieces, feeling a mix of frustration and helplessness. I'm no car expert, and the thought of dealing with repair shops was daunting. The hours spent waiting, the uncertainty of not knowing the cost, and the hassle of explaining the problem without knowing the technical jargon, it was overwhelming. In those moments, I dreamt of a simpler solution. Picture a virtual garage where you just type in the issue and get instant professional assistance. A platform where you have the choice, engage in a chat with our AI mechanic team, or simply upload an image of the damage. The AI then automatically analyzes the image and swiftly generates an offer for the spare parts and repairs, all communicated through an email. Today, we're diving into constructing an interactive chat from scratch, bolstered by an API powered by AutoGen agents. Part 1 will focus on building the chat flow, while Part 2 will center around developing the API. This streamlined process is easy to follow, and you'll have access to the source code, setting you up perfectly to create your own AI-powered agent solutions. Stay tuned until the end of this video, and we'll reward you with a special surprise as a thank you for joining us on this journey. All right, let's embark on our digital odyssey with Voiceflow, our trusty sidekick in this adventure. Think of Voiceflow as our magic wand, ready to conjure up powerful chatbots for websites in the blink of an eye. First up, we're creating a new assistant. Let's name this digital wizard and teach it to converse in English. We're greeted with a setup wizard, but hey, we're explorers. Let's start from scratch and unravel the mysteries ourselves. Our first act of magic, conjuring a text block to welcome visitors with a message that's warm, inviting, and possibly a bit cheeky. Next, let's add a dash of personality with an image, maybe something that shows off our team's charming faces. It's all about making a great first impression. Now, it's time to ask our guests how we can be their digital superhero today. We're setting up response buttons for now, but soon we'll dive into the ocean of free text responses and fish out their true intentions. Let's offer two magical portals. I want to buy spare parts and I want to lodge a complaint. For now, we'll travel down the spare parts path. We're sidestepping the complaint department. Let's keep things positive and focus on helping our visitors find what they need. Time for a test run. We're greeted, asked for our heart's desire, and voila, a follow-up question appears as if by magic. Let's capture the visitor's wishes like a genie in a bottle using the capture block. To see if everything works, we'll have it output this once. This is only temporary for debugging, and we will remove it later. We test again, but this time not the entire flow, but we can press the little play button on each block, and then it will execute from that point. And we see that it works perfectly, meaning the user's input is displayed to us. Now in the next step, we want to not only display the user's request, but actually send it to our API endpoint. For this, we create a new block, and this time we choose API from the list. This API is a crystal ball, revealing availability and prices with the help of our autonomous agent elves. I have already created a small endpoint and deployed it on render, and we can test what the return result is based on this last input of the user. In just about 5 minutes, we're going to build this API endpoint from scratch. A nicer way to specify the required query parameter is not directly in the URL, but in the headers. Now we test the request and give it a triparameter windshield And we see our response, and indeed we see that it is in stock. We can then formulate the response to the user based on this successful API access. For this, we choose an AI block, where the response can be answered using a language model like GPT. We enter a prompt, just as we would do in the GPT interface. We tell it to answer the customer's question. For this, we give it the user's last input and also the response from our API endpoint. But first, we need to capture this magic in a bottle to refer back to it, and that's our next trick. For this, we have to go back to our API block, and there we have the menu item capture response. There we can give it the exact name of the JSON key, and to find this out, I run the request again. Ah, the key is spare parts. Now we can access it and assign its power to a variable. We can then access it via response point spare parts and assign the value to a variable. We name this variable server response. We can then use this new variable directly in our prompt. Furthermore, we want to give GPT some output instructions via a system message, especially to define the format of the response. So we tell it to please respond in the following format. The item is currently available for a certain price, for example, X dollars. Now we can actually test our flow completely. Building a full-fledged chatbot with API access in 5 minutes is like speed dating with code. You hope for no awkward mistakes. We say we want spare parts. It asks us what exactly we want. In this case, we want a windshield again. The API request is made, and we see that the item is currently available and can be converted for $200. Now we can prepare the chat itself for our website. For this, we give it a brand image and an icon. And we can now test the result in a new tab. Basically, we have two options here. We can have a single page, or we can also overlay it on an existing page. We go through the process again. This time, I'm looking for a Tesla display. And we find out that the Tesla display is available and can be provided for a price of 349 euros. Now we can make a few small improvements. First, we don't want the user's input to be displayed again one-to-one. So we remove this block and connect it directly with our query to the API. Then we make it a bit more compact. And I had promised that we would also find a solution so that you don't have to press buttons. Let's first understand the challenge at hand. As it stands, users can express their intent for spare parts only through button selections. However, in a truly convenient chat experience, users might type something like, "I'm searching for a spare part for my Tesla." Ideally, our chatbot should recognize and understand such sentences. Sadly, this level of comprehension isn't part of our current setup. For this scenario, Voiceflow offers intents that function like virtual buttons, intuitively deciphering the user's direction of inquiry. The more examples we provide of potential user queries for this path, the better Voiceflow becomes at grasping the customer's intention. We let GPT generate even more, teaching it the art of anticipation. Okay, let's see if it works. This time, I'll type that I need some spare parts. Alas, our digital genie seems puzzled. We need to prepare it better for its task. With a click on Train Assistant, we hope to improve our spell's understanding. We try again, asking for a few spare parts. Success! Our digital genie inquires further. We request a windshield, and the response is swift and accurate. But now, let's delve into the wizardry of building the API that conjures these responses. As promised, we're beginning from scratch. Initially, we set up a virtual environment, a crucial step for cleanly separating our dependencies. Activating this environment is our next move. We then create an app.py file. Our first task is to import Flask, but before that, let's install it along with AutoGen. Having installed the packages, we're ready to import them. From Flask, we import Flask, JSONify for JSON conversion, and request. For AutoGen, we only need the core AutoGen module. We proceed to establish a new Flask app and create an endpoint that's ready to run. We then define the function that's triggered upon endpoint activation, naming it spare parts for clarity. Next, we fetch the parameter from the request, specifying the parameter name query. We start with a simple return to test functionality, giving back a JSON with the query. Now it's time to set up the server. This ensures automatic launching with the Python file. We use the standard check for main to make sure the script runs only when directly executed. We initiate the server in debug mode for clear output visibility and bind it to the IP 0.0.0.0 for external accessibility, choosing port 80. We're now ready to test the server startup by running the Python file. Once started, we can easily test our GET endpoint in the browser. Upon testing, we observe that spare parts is correctly returned. Adding a parameter results in its return as well. With this success, we move on to integrating AutoGen, starting with setting up the configuration. We ensure the config file is in the same directory. This file allows us to specify the language models available, keeping it simple with just one model, GPT-4, and including the necessary API key. In my case, I won't add the API key directly because I prefer to set it as an environment variable. Now it's time to create our first assistant using Assistant Agent. We give it a name and configuration using the config list we just created. We also need a user proxy to mediate between us and AutoGen in this group chat setup. We then set its human input mode. AutoGen offers various interaction modes. We opt for never mode for fully automated agent operation upon request receipt. It's crucial to specify termination conditions to conclude the process. We terminate the process when an agent replies terminate. Everything is now in place to start the chat. We initiate it with the initiate chat method, providing the assistant and a relevant message. Our goal is for the assistant to provide spare part availability and pricing, concluding with terminate. As it's not yet database connected, we allow it to freely find information. We pass the request and specify the desired output format. We're now ready to retrieve the response accessible through chat message from the user proxy, specifically from the assistant. Choosing the second message, as counting starts from zero in computing, we get its content. With the response in hand, we're set to return it. That concludes the setup. Now we can proceed to test the code. Let's position both windows side by side. And input windshield as a parameter. We notice an issue with the API key, which we'll promptly address. Correcting the API key issue, we see the chat initiate successfully. The system plans to check availability as expected, but we need to ensure it doesn't execute unwanted code. To ensure the agents refrain from utilizing code for the time being, we need to explicitly instruct them. Once we've updated the prompt with these specific directives, we can proceed with another trial run. Excellent! This is precisely the output we were aiming for. Following our specific instructions, the response now perfectly matches Voiceflow's expectations. Now, if we revisit the API request within Voiceflow, we'll notice that we've received precisely this response. This observation effectively closes the loop in our process. Now, one might argue that employing AutoGen for generating such random responses seems like overkill, but bear with me. What we've done here is lay the groundwork for integrating our group chat agents from the last part of the series, which are capable of accessing an SQL database and sending real emails. In our next video, we'll bring these elements together and truly make the magic happen. Ready to see more and dive deeper? If you're excited about our next video and want to witness the magic unfold, show your support by giving this video a like. And if you're eager to get your hands on the complete series and the source code, just drop a comment below. Your feedback drives our journey forward.